Hey, thanks for watching this video on our Hunter ADAS and DAS 3000. Today we're going to be covering the eyesight or camera on a 2022 Subaru Outback. It's a limited, it did have a windshield replacement, and as part of our requirements per Subaru, anytime that was been replaced due to the damage, we're going to go through the calibration of that. So we're going to show you how to do that next. Stay tuned. So we've got our VCI hooked up to our DLC. We're gonna go ahead and get into diagnostics and select our ADAS calibration to begin the process of doing the actual calibration. We're into our diagnostic screen and we're gonna go ahead and select ADAS calibration and see what's available for us. We have front-facing camera and we also have blind spot monitoring that we can do calibrations on this vehicle. Today we're worried about that front-facing camera, because again, we replaced that windshield. So now we have our two tests that are shown here. This is a little bit of a unique system that you'll find with Subaru. We have two different tests here to do: static camera calibration and dynamic. If you've seen any of our videos in the past, you'll understand that there's a difference. Static is your DAS 3000 rack and a calibrated target board that you're going to use, and dynamic is driving. If you were to select the dynamic one first, it'll tell you you should have done the static one prior to doing the driving one. So we're gonna do the static one here. The second part of that dynamic adjustment will be done on the road. So this is a dual phase that you've gotta do to the Subaru for the eyesight or the front windshield cameras. So we're gonna select the static camera calibration. It says dual, there are two cameras in that windshield. So now it's going to give you a list of all the things that you're going to need to do this successfully. Of course, the DAS 3000, your target board. Now this function is used to adjust the lane departure warning camera. And we're going to do this when either the ECU or the camera has been replaced, or the windshield has been replaced as well, just as in the case with ours. Remember our required preconditions. We've talked about this ad nauseum probably in a lot of the videos, where we always remind you that these things must be done to ensure a successful calibration, including a level surface, properly aligned with correct tire size and correct tire pressure. Fuel tank is full. No unnecessary cargo that could cause the vehicle to pitch or tilt in any unnecessary ways. Make sure no objects other than the target boards are in front of the vehicle, and eliminate extra ambient lighting. Good lighting, not too dim, but not too bright either. This is not recommended outdoors either, as the sunlight itself could cause the actual camera calibration to fail. So Subaru tells you don't do this outside. And this is the amount of distance that we're going to need to be able to do this. So give yourself a little bit of distance, because we're going to need at least 4,000 millimeters between the actual target board and the camera to be able to get a successful calibration. So we're gonna press continue now. It's gonna ask us to hook up our cameras. It's got 4,000 millimeters shown right there. We select done, do not change that. That is the requirement, that is specifications for Subaru. So we can press continue. Now it's gonna ask us to attach our wheel clamps, one to the left front wheel and the other one to the right rear wheel. So we're gonna go ahead and set those up real quick before I press continue. So right now you can see the images, the camera images, showing the actual target boards themselves. You should be able to see them clearly. And once the camera sees it clearly, it'll allow you to press continue. Must be fully visible before you can continue on. Now it's gonna have us move that left front wheel clamp to the rear of the left. So we're gonna go ahead and move that back before I press continue. At this point, we're gonna move our DAS 3000 to the required position to get the correct distance that we need. Once we have our green check mark, you can press continue. and it's going to ask us to lock this into place. And we're going to press continue and move on. So the next thing we're going to do is install our target board, and it's going to have us attach both target hangers number one to the frame at the A position. And we're going to use our Subaru 3.1 Eyesight board, and we're going to install that using Z as the upper clamp, and we're going to install that with these ones right here and center it on the actual ADAS rack or the DAS 3000 rack. Once you have everything set up, go ahead and press continue. Make sure your pitch, you're going to be set the number two position, and then make sure your level. Adjust accordingly using the dial to make sure your board's level using the level indicator provided. Now it's asking us to disconnect our cameras and step away from the calibration area. So remove the scan tool from the platform, and of course, like I said, disconnect your USB cables, which are your cameras, and step away from the calibration area. We've moved away from that as well. We're gonna go ahead and press continue. And we're gonna select continue to begin calibration. Calibration is in progress right now. So right now it says target distance incorrect. There is no reason to be worried at this point. Some might get a little confused by this and maybe panic a little bit. But confirm your distance from target is correct. We are correct. I am that 4,000 millimeters, so I know that's not the problem. Our lighting conditions are good as well, and it's a brand new clean windshield. But it says here, if all are correct, continue to the next screen. So that's what you got to be careful of. We are within specifications of all of the things that are asked of us, so you don't have to panic and press exit at this point. We're going to press continue and allow it to continue on. And of course, now it says distance correction complete. So it said it was incomplete before. It actually just kind of calibrated itself now to do that. Camera accuracy, 89%. Excellent. Press continue. And now, of course, now we are at our calibration successfully completed. Next step, to ensure proper operation of the system, cycle the key off then on, and we'll do that real quick. We'll cycle the key off as it asks to do so. So after cycling the ignition, it came back into our ADAS calibration main screen. We did generate a report as well, indicating that the front windshield calibration was successful. But remember, I said this was a two-part phase or a two-part test or calibration that you need to do. So we're going to go back into front-facing camera, and then now we've got to do the dynamic. So this procedure will auto-adjust the Eyesight stereo camera. But like I said, they do recommend to do the static one first, then come back to your dynamic one. Carry out this procedure when, and it's again, after static camera calibration has been performed. So we've already done that. And it even also says it down here in the caution that it should only be done after that. This procedure provides a more precise adjustment of the Eyesight system after a static calibration has been performed. We'll press continue again. Now you'll see this one here before aiming. Make sure the engine is running because we're going to be driving it. Turn the active lane, keep, and cruise to off, and then hold down the pre-collision brake off switch for 2 seconds to turn off the pre-collision brake condition. And of course, at the end, it says this procedure will require the vehicle to be driven. That's what we're going to do next. We're going to take our ADASLink into our Subaru and hit the road. All right, so make sure, again, we're going to turn everything off, our active lane, keep, and cruise to off, and the pre-collision brake to off. It says to hold down the switch for 2 seconds. On this vehicle itself, on this Subaru, what we're actually going to do is find our pre-collision in our menu button on our infotainment center. So I'm going to select the car and get into the driving assistance. We can see the pre-collision braking is on. We need it off. So I'm going to select that off for now. Okay. And lane departure, I'm turning it off as well. Of course, we'll make sure to turn that back on and test drive the vehicle after we've gone through our time, or after we've gone through the entire dynamic driving condition right now. So everything's off. You can see on the dash that it's off. It's indicating in my tachometer, lane departure and pre-collision are off as indicated. And my main cruise control switch is also off. If I was to toggle that so you could see what it looked like on the dash, there would be cruise control on with the car, and then there it is off. So we've got all three things turned off right now. We're ready to drive this. And more importantly, I have my seatbelt on when we go hit the road. We're at a stop sign and we're getting ready to try and get to a nice long stretch of road because the following conditions must be maintained before the adjustment can be completed, and that's a flat and straight road. Must be greater than 25 miles an hour. We need lines on both sides of the vehicle, and we also gotta try and find a vehicle to maintain some distance behind while we're driving. So those are all the things that we're gonna do to look for while we're driving. So the calibration is in progress right now. You have a status screen displayed on my ADASLink. Right now we're at zero. It's gonna take a little while to do these. And I also had said, once this is complete, my indicators will blink at me to let me know that the system is through calibrating, which is a much safer thing to watch than obviously the screen that's on my ADASLink while I'm trying to drive. Sometimes the hardest part of the driving part is finding a suitable place to do this where it can see what it needs to see and that you can maintain the speed. All right. Finished calibrating. If I was able to pull off the side somewhere safe, I'm going to switch the ignition off. And after our driving, our calibration was successfully completed. So as of right now, we have successfully done the static and the dynamic calibration of this Subaru Eyesight system. Did take a little while. One thing, you just be patient. When you're driving, give yourself plenty of time to complete this. It does take a little while, so be patient. And of course, the last thing that we're going to do now is I'm going to re-engage all of our safety systems and test drive it and make sure that it's working. Pre-collision's on. Testing the pre-collision system as well, make sure that it's working as designed. Of course, we're in a construction zone, so it saw the cones and told us we were off, which is great. And it also picked up the car in front of us that we're driving. So we just went ahead and verified that our system is operating as designed. If I veer over to the right or left, the lane departure system is warning me that I did so. So it's seeing the lines as it should. And I'm not off by any means. It's not telling me I'm getting too close to one when I'm really not. The system is operating as designed. Our pre-collision is also working. It's detecting all the cars in front of us. Even though I didn't calibrate it, it's a good thing to check while we're out on our test drive to make sure that it's operating as designed as well. Right now, I'm confident that our Subaru Eyesight is working as designed. It's detecting the lanes, keeping us from departing from the middle of those lines. And everything seems to be working great. I can safely return this vehicle back to the customer knowing that everything is working as it should. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more of these videos that are coming out on the ADAS Link and the DAS 3000 by Hunter. Thanks again for watching.